In the last video, I derived Newton's method to find the zeros of a system of nonlinear equations. Let's look at a particular application here so you see how it all hangs together. As the example, I want to talk about the Lorenz equations. These are a famous system of nonlinear equations that ushered in the study of chaotic dynamics. Lorenz was a meteorologist that wanted to see how unstable the weather is. So the equations are x dot, that's dx dt, equals sigma times y minus x, sigma is a parameter, y dot equals x times r minus z minus y, r is a parameter, and z dot equals xy minus beta z, beta is a parameter. So there are three parameters in this equation. These are nonlinear equations because of the x times z term and the x times y term. Okay, so we're going to use Newton's method, or at least set up Newton's method, to find the fixed points of these equations. Those are the values where x dot equals y dot equals z dot equals zero. Those are called fixed points, because if you put x, y, and z at those values, then the derivatives are zero, so they stay there. They don't move. So we have three equations. I'm just going to do this without simplifying. So we have sigma of y minus x equals zero. We have x times r minus z minus y equals zero. And we have xy minus beta z equals zero. You could actually find the analytical solution of these equations, and I ask you to do that as a homework problem. But here I'm interested in finding, setting up a numerical method to find the solutions of this equation. So this function here we can call f. So this one is our f of, there's three variables here, x, y, and z. This one here I'll call g of x, y, and z. And this one here I'll call h of x, y, and z. Then we need to find the Jacobian matrix. So to find the Jacobian matrix, we need the partial derivatives. So let's do that. So the partial of f with respect to x is going to be minus sigma. The partial of f with respect to y is going to be sigma. And the partial derivative of f with respect to z, there's no z dependence here, so that's zero. This will be the first row of our Jacobian matrix. The second row will be the partial of g with respect to x. That will be r minus z. The partial of g with respect to y is negative 1. And the partial of g with respect to z is going to be minus x. Okay, finally h, the partial of h with respect to x is y. The partial of h with respect to y is x. And the partial of h with respect to z is minus beta. Okay? That's our going to be our Jacobian matrix. So our iteration equation then, to find the values of at the n plus 1 stage, say that we're in the nth stage of the iteration, we'll be solving the matrix equation, which is the Jacobian. So the matrix equation will be F sub x, so minus sigma, F sub y, sigma, times F sub z, zero. G sub x at the nth stage of the iteration will be r minus z sub n, the nth value of z. G sub y is minus 1, and g sub z is minus x sub n, the nth value of x. And then the third row of the matrix will be the h partials. So h sub x will be y sub n, the nth value of y. H sub y is x sub n, the nth value of x, and h sub z is minus beta. So that's our Jacobian matrix, and that will multiply our delta xn, delta yn, and delta zn, our correction, and that's supposed to be equal to our right-hand side. So that's equal to the right-hand side, which will be minus the column vector, which will be f evaluated at xn, yn. So the first column will be sigma y sub n minus x sub n. The second row, that's the first row. The second row will be g, so x sub n r minus z sub n minus y sub n. And the third row will be h, which will be x sub n y sub n minus beta z sub n. Okay? And then this is our iteration of the Jacobian equation. So you start with, the way it works, of course, is you start with x naught, y naught, and z naught. So that's your initial value. And then you compute delta x naught, delta y naught, delta z naught by solving this matrix equation, right? By Gaussian elimination. It's basically inverting this matrix. And then you get x1 would be then x0 plus delta x0, y1 would be y0 plus delta y0, and z1 would be z0 plus delta z0, which is the solution of the matrix equation. And then you keep going, iterating, okay? I ask you to do this for homework in MATLAB. So this is just setting it up for you. So let me summarize. We're given a system of nonlinear equations. Here it's differential equations that are called the Lorenz equations. We're trying to use Newton's method to find the fixed points of this equation. So we set the time derivatives to zero. Then we end up with three couple nonlinear equations. We're looking for the roots of these three equations. And I set up an iteration scheme based on Newton's method. So we have the Jacobian matrix, which we compute by finding the partial derivatives of f, g, and h. These are the increments, and then this is the right-hand side of the equation. So to solve, we start off with some initial guess, x naught, y naught, and z naught. We plug into this matrix equation, solve the matrix equation, find delta x naught, delta y naught, and delta z naught, and then we compute x1, y1, and z1. And then we repeat, okay? So it's an iteration solution. Good luck. Try this in MATLAB. See if you can compute the roots of the Lorenz equations. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.